I got to wonder, the man can spin a yarn, as you can tell, you know. And I know you seem to be doing all over this festival, which is great. You know.
Well, it's a great 4-day event, and I'm glad to be part of even a tiny slice of it.
Yeah, and we used to sometimes when after I met Son, sometimes we'd bring Son over to Brian's house, and we'd play music, mess around over there and stuff, and get primed sometimes.
Yeah, that was one thing about Son. You really couldn't get him to sing or play unless you had some sort of primer.
Little primer. Yeah, that's what a lot of times people ask me, oh, you know, oh, what's the first thing you learned from Son House? And aside from being, first time I actually met him at Joe Beard's house, we were just sitting in Joe's living room, and Son sang so loud that the windows were rattling in the panes, you know. And then I started going by his house, and I figured it's, because, well, people always, you know, they talk about his drinking and what have you, which, you know, everybody does from time to time, but I learned that, you know, I took a little bottle of brandy or something, and I figured, well, we'll each have a nip, and I handed him the bottle, which he handed me just the bottle back. So, if you want to say he taught me anything, that's what he taught me. But, you know, I spent a lot of time hanging around his house and doing a lot of, not blues in the house, because he couldn't sing blues in the house. He wouldn't sing blues in the house because of Evie, his wife. That was her rule. So even if she wasn't home, he would never sing blues in the house. But he would at Brian's house, that's for sure.
And if he goes there.
Yeah, there was one that's one story he was talking about, what the blues is between a, strictly between a man and a woman, and he was showing kind of how it went. How did that go? You know what I'm talking about?
He would often talk about the blues and the church, and the church and the devil. And when he would refer to the church, his eyes would roll up in his head as if to look to the heavens. And then when he would talk about the devil, he would point down at his crotch.
That is the devil. Which, well, being as young as I would, you know, Brian knew what he was talking about, but, you know, I'm like, Brian, where's this guy coming from? You know? But we had a lot of good times. We're playing at, like, Wine Press and Genesee Co-op and a bunch of different places around.
On the stoop of his apartment, just hanging out.
Yeah. And his wife, Evie, always kept his slide, so when we go to pick him up for a gig, he'd be all ready to go, and what, we'd watch him shave for 45 minutes sometimes.
Yeah, we'll go back to that in a minute about shaving. I have a story to tell about that.
Yeah, I might have to leave the room for that one. But Evie always had his slide, and we knew, of course, knew where she kept, but she'd go under every cushion in the living room, all the cupboards in the kitchen, and she'd look behind everything and go, I just don't know where that thing is, I don't know. And then finally she'd get in the bedroom and find it up on the shelf in the closet, you know, which is where she kept it, and she'd go, oh, there it is. I mean, she would just crack up, so I don't know. When I get that old, well, actually, I already am that entertained by things.
Good question. How old was John, his son, when you first met him?
How old? Well, that's a matter of conjecture, actually, because on his birth certificate says, what, 1902, and I met him in 71, so that makes him around, somewhere around 70, I guess. But Dick Waterman thinks that he was actually born in what, maybe 1886 or 96? He thinks he was older because when in 43, when he came to Rochester, he was too old to get a job as a porter on the railroad, so he falsified a birth certificate so he could get a job. Well, you asked Dick Waterman about that, which I guess, I don't know if he's here yet, but... Yeah, but he has the greatest photos, which I'm sure a lot of you people have seen him out there, and he's got great stories to go along with each and every one of them too. And he's quite a chiropractor himself. The shaving? Should we say that for later? Or?
You may remember this, John. I think you were there. It was when he had moved to the tower apartments over...
Danforth Towers.
Yes, after living in Cornhill. And I forget what the reason for us going over there to visit was. And he wasn't playing much guitar at that point in his life. But he was in the process of shaving when we got to the house, and we went into the bathroom with him just to, continue visiting. And he lathered up his face and getting ready to shave his face, and then he lathered up his eyebrows and shaved his eyebrows off.
Man gotta look good. I don't remember him shaving his eyebrows, but I was already shaving by that point, Brian, so I didn't need to watch as closely as you did.
Shaving is something I haven't done in a long time. More than 4 years. In fact, when I reminded you of that story about shaving his eyebrows off, you said, "What eyebrows?"
I don't notice some things, I don't know. Alright, let's see. Let's see what I got here. Yes. Thank you. you. I was getting a little too high there. But that's a kind of an amalgamation of a number of different kind of Sunhouse things. And sometimes when we do gigs, Son would get on a groove and he would play for like half hour, 20 minutes, half hour, 45 minutes, just verse after verse and verses we had never heard before.
And sometimes it would take him about half hour, 45 minutes to tell his story before he started playing.
Yeah. Or unless he started.
Oh, yeah.
Started buck dancing. He did a lot better than I did.
First time for everything, I guess.
Although Brian's a pretty good dancer, though, I tell you.
Tired and had enough. Lean on your knee.
the sun go down, go down. Thank you very much. Thank you. I did a lot of that slower kind of stuff. Excuse my voice. It's so dry up here, for one thing. It is.
In New Orleans, everybody's dry.
Yeah, right. Everybody's trying to get dry. But yeah, I mean, what is it, 65% humidity, which is like in New Orleans when we get the humidity that low, everybody's like, it's like a holiday, you know? Thank you.
so good.
I said, look at honey, honey, what
Thank you. Well, hey, I think maybe we should get Brian to play a little bass on a couple of tunes. What do you think?
What's it gonna be, John?
It's a 7G.
I figured
it was. If not for Brian, I would not be here now. Please. Change tuning.
I just asked John if he could play a specific tune on the road. It was in Rochester, it was living on Griffith Street. Right. Behind the glass onion. Anybody remember the glass onion? And John had a coal stove in his parlor there. Did I give you that story?
You helped me move it there, I know that.
That's why I got a bad back.
Yeah. Yeah, it's one of those big old, like a potbelly coal stove with the isinglass windows in it, and thing weighed a ton and put out a ton of soot. But man, it was great because you could stoke the thing up, and then we go off on a gig, and when we got back, the thing would still be going, you know? So. Try to do that with them old-fangled wood stoves. Let me see where I'm going over this over.
Yeah.
so cold. Snow, ice, and the sun won't shine. Some couldn't play any blues in the house, but we do a lot of spiritual stuff, so it's something that something we actually used to do.
I'm playing with Brian. I never get a chance to.
Can we do one more? Yeah?
Sacred Ground?
Is that
Sacred Ground?
Yes.
Yeah.
Better not do that. I'm not sure I really have those changes.
Played that tune together before.
We so. Didn't? No, oh, I'm sorry. I might not have played it before either.
I've always heard John sing the acapella. So.
Well, I said, don't mind people grinning in your face. But I tell you, I just been with the allergies and everything. My voice is so hoarse that I couldn't make it through half of anything. Yes. Well. Half a half gallon of chocolate ice cream, see about besides that though. Somebody wanted me to do this song. It's kind of I actually got it from Snooks England, but it's same Sunhouse used to do stuff like this too, but it's kind of someone I like to take New Orleans and the Delta and put them together, right? very much. Let's have a hand for Brian Williams there. Thank you.